Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Maria, and on my channel I create videos around everything nursing, and I also have a handful of lifestyle content. I am trying to get to 10k subscribers, so I'd really appreciate it if you subscribe to my channel, and also if you liked the video. Not only does it tell YouTube that you would like to see more videos like this, it also helps with the growth of my channel. So without further ado, let's get into the video. In this video, I'm going to be sharing what is in my nursing work bag. I've done these before on my channel, but it's been a very long time. The first time I did it was probably over maybe 3 or 4 years ago when I was a student nurse. The second time I did it was when I became a newly qualified nurse, so we all know how that went. I probably had a handful of stuff in my bag that I didn't need. And now the third time that I'm doing it is right now. Right now I've been working, right now I've been working as a nurse for approximately 2 years, and obviously with everything that's going on, that kind of has influenced what is now in my bag. So I thought, let's just share, film a video and share with you guys what's in my bag. So the first thing that I want to say is this is the bag that I have. This bag is the Fiorelli bag, I think I'm pronouncing it right, and it's really like a decent size. It's not too big and it's not too small. Out of all the bags that I've had for nursing and placement, this is probably the smallest bag. Yeah, I'll leave a link for it in the description box if anybody is interested. And this bag has got a tiny zipper at the front. It's got a main compartment, and then it also has, you know, sections within that compartment. It has a zip on the side as well. First thing first, obvious, everyone's got this. I've seen people hanging this in their car. I've got a handful of simple face masks, because obviously with everything that's going on, wherever you go, you have to take a face mask, unless you know you're going to be out in a very public space. For example, if you're in a park where there's barely anyone there, then you won't need one. But anything from going to the chemist, going to work, taking public transport, getting into a taxi, you're going to need a face mask. So I always make sure I've got a handful of simple face masks. I've just got two here, so that's that there. And then I've got some tissue as well, nothing interesting about that. I have got £5 cash. I don't really know, why do I have £5 cash? I've got £5 cash, yep. And then I also have a handful of gift cards that I haven't already used. I've got an Argos, I believe this is a £5 Argos gift card. This is an M&S gift card that I got from work this year, £15. And then this is another M&S, I got it for Christmas, yeah, because of Christmas period, every year they give us like a Christmas gift, and this year it was an M&S £15 gift card. And then I also have my M&S £15 gift card that I got from the same job last year. I'm not sure how much is on the one that I got last year. I'm gonna assume that it's £15 as well, but I don't know. I should actually use this. But I have been to M&S several times since I've got this gift card, but I've never had it on me. So I'm like, okay, I need to use these gift cards. Let me just stick them in my bag. And then I also have my house key as well. A 20p coin, just some change. And then I also have two simple rings that I got from Primark. Let me actually stick them on now. And yeah, this is what they, this, wait, let me just put this on this finger. This is what they're looking like. Now let's get over into the side section of this bag. So I'm just gonna like stick my hand in here and take everything out. So I've done that. The first thing that I have is the card of my work. So it's got the hospital that I work at, the number of the ward, and the name of the ward. I thought it was just good that I have this. And then on the back of the card, this is really bad. I told one of my colleagues that I've done this, and he was like, oh my gosh, Maria, not even my grandmother would do that. But on this card, I also have my name badge for work. It says, hello, my name is Maria, staff nurse, and then, you know, obviously the hospital that I work at as well. And then another badge, which also has my name on it, where I work, staff nurse. And then on the back of the badge, it's got, what is this called? Penicillin facts. And it basically says, if your patient is allergic to penicillin, here are a handful of antibiotics that they can have, antibiotics that they should take with caution, and antibiotics that are completely contraindicated. So if you are interested in getting a card like this, then I recommend just go to your pharmacy, like the pharmacy department, and I can guarantee you they'll have like a card or a leaflet like this that they can give with you, and you can just take a picture of. And then here I've got a post-it note. Nothing really interesting. I think, yeah, it's just got a set of obs, rest, 18, heart rate 74, SATs 94, blood pressure 124 over 68. So yeah, that's why I actually don't need this. Okay, so let's go into the main section. The main section of the bag here, and we'll just start from the top. Okay, so we have even more face masks. So zip up small section. In here, I have a wallet. This is not my wallet. I actually found this wallet on the street on my way to work, and I was able to contact the guy on Instagram. So he's given me like the address that he wants me to post it to. So I'm just gonna post it to his house the next time I go to the post office. So that's what we have here. So yeah, I'm glad that I was able to find him on Instagram, which I think is pretty cool. So yeah, I've got his wallet here. And then I also have my purse. And in my purse, I don't have a lot of stuff. This is my work purse. Well, I don't want to say my work purse, but this purse has been configured so I just take it to work. So if I'm like not going to work, or if I'm like going anywhere else, and obviously I add like the relevant cards and stuff. But there's been several times where I thought I lost my purse, and guys, because I had so many cards in there, I honestly, like, I was losing it. I didn't know what to do. You only put the essential in there. Don't be putting all 3-4 of your credit debit cards. There's literally no need for it. I also have my blue light discount card. Guys, get a blue light discount card if you don't already have one. A handful of places are offering not only NHS staff but also care staff discounts. I know Superdrug, the last time I checked, they do 20% discount if you present them with a... it changes all the time, but at one point they were offering 20% discount if you had a blue light card and or your work card and a Superdrug card. So definitely check it out. I also have my Holland and Barrett card, because I'd probably say Holland and Barrett and Superdrug are probably the stores that I visit the most, so it makes sense that I have a Holland and Barrett card and collect my discounts. In that section, I also have my rail card, and obviously I've got my Oyster card, because I commute back and forth to and from London. So Oyster card is super helpful. One tip I want to give you guys is that if you do have an Oyster card and you have a rail card, make sure you go to one of the underground stations, go to one of the members of staff, and tell them to connect your rail card to your Oyster card. Because once they connect your rail card to your Oyster card, every time you use your Oyster card at certain times of the day, you'll be eligible for a discount. I also have a pair of headphones, night shift, I don't know, do some e-learning or whatever. And then I also have some yellow soft paraffin. Yes, this is what I have in my bag. Last shift at work, I was working at a different part of the hospital, and the air was so dry to the point where my lips actually started bleeding. And I was like, no. And I'm just going to pull it out. First things first is envelopes. Like I said, I do want to post this wallet off to this guy. And then I also have some Mitchum Women's Deodorant Triple Odor Defense. I have another face mask. I have my water bottles, reusable, and I got it from TK Maxx, if anyone's interested. I got it during Boxing Day, I believe. No, that's a lie. Boxing Day, we were all inside. When did I get it? I got it last year, TK Maxx. It was on sale for £1.80, and this holds just under 500 mils of water. Next section is obviously, you know, umbrella. Live in the UK, it rains all the time. It can be 32 degrees outside and I will not be surprised if it rains for like at least 1 minute. The thing I love about this umbrella, it's got like a button here, so all you have to do is press the button and then the whole thing opens up. I've got some toothpaste hanging around. I also have a pair of cycle shorts. Some of you guys are thinking, why do you have cycle shorts? I have cycle shorts because obviously now when I'm at work, because of COVID and everything, we don't take our uniform into work. We have scrubs. So when we go into work, we pick up our scrubs and then we put them on. And yeah, I like putting these cycle shorts on underneath the scrubs, just because, you know, I know myself and I know a handful of other nurses who at least wear cycling shorts or leggings or long johns underneath their scrubs. So yeah. These are the cycling shorts that I wear underneath my scrubs. Yeah, these cycle shorts take up barely any space. Look, it literally like fits in my hand like that. Okay, and I've also got a vest. So this black vest just stays in my bag, and obviously I switch out when I need to. I also have a very tiny Denman brush, two bits of A4 paper that I folded, and it's basically just talking about different machines. One of my previous shifts, I was in ICU and the guy was just telling me about the different machines and all that stuff. So I just took a whole bunch of notes on here. I've got my toothbrush. Obviously, why have toothpaste if you've got a toothbrush? So I can scrub-a-dub-dub, brush my teeth. And then obviously, well, maybe not obviously, but I always have at least one sanitary towel, even if I'm not on, because if someone approaches me saying, do you have any sanitary towels? I want to be able to be like, yes, I have one that you could have. Right at the bottom of the bag, I also have two first class stamps. And that is literally everything that I take in my bag. Look, it's all empty. There's nothing in there. And the reason why I love this bag is because it's small and convenient and it fits everything that I need to fit in it. And I still have spare space. And I've managed to get myself down into a system where I don't have to change my bag all the time. So what I mean by that is like, if I've got a shift on Monday and then I've got like a shift on Thursday, I'll go to work on Monday, come back, literally drop my bag off, don't even have to do anything to it, anything at all, unless I've like worn the vest and I'll change the vest out, I don't have to do anything to it. And then when it comes to my shift on Thursday, I literally just pick up the bag and go. The only things that I might have to check in my bag every so often are my keys and then maybe like my lip gloss, because I only have two. Well, I only have one lip gloss and one lip bar. Those are the only things. But let's just say if the hospital calls me now and says, hey Marie, we need you for a bank shift, I can literally just pick up my bag and go, and I know that I've got everything in here that I need to, you know, get to work, do what I need to do at work, and then come back. So yeah, some of you guys might be wondering why I don't take my uniform to work. And as I've mentioned earlier on in the video, I don't take my uniform to work because everything that's happening now, we are all provided with scrubs. And again, as I've mentioned in one of my previous what's in my nursing bag video, I don't take a stethoscope with me to work. Depending on where you work, there will be a stethoscope by the patient's bedside. There are some wards where you've got stethoscopes, where you've got every equipment that you need by the patient's bedside. So I don't need to take a stethoscope. I don't need to take in, you know, fancy tourniquets. I don't need to take a SATS monitoring machine. Why? Because I work for the NHS, and the trust that I work for is, I would say, okay, they're pretty good in terms of equipment. The equipment doesn't always work, so you're spending a bit longer trying to find equipment that works. But for the most part, we have everything that we need to, you know, do our job properly. Like I said, it doesn't always work, but if this one doesn't work, best believe the one, you know, in the next bay works. So yeah, that's pretty much everything that I have in my bag. Let me know if you're shocked by what I have in my bag. Did you think I would have more items? Did you think I would have less items? And yeah, that's all I kind of have to say. If you have any questions, make sure you put it in the comments box below. Thank you guys for watching. Like I said, I am trying to get to 10k subscribers, so make sure you subscribe to my channel, give this video a like, and thank you for watching. Bye.